You'd think by now scientists would have learned everything there is to know about one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms, H2O. But we learn new things about water all the time. Really, we do. Hey there, Hydro friends. Trace here for DNews. Water is important for, well, everything living on Earth. It's part of every single cell in our bodies, and all plants and animals need water to survive. But despite its ubiquity, water is incredibly unique. It goes from solid to gas in a smaller temperature range than many other compounds. Plus, when you cool it down into ice, it expands and becomes less dense than its liquid form, which doesn't happen with most other substances. A study in December 2016's Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences showed that ice doesn't even melt the way you think it does. Instead of melting all at once in sort of a continuous process, it goes layer by layer. The top layer is only 45 nanometers at its thickest, or 1/1000th the thickness of a human hair. And it stays liquid like well below 0 degrees Celsius, which is the reason ice is slippery. In fact, this new study showed that it's liquid like even at negative 38 degrees. That's slick. And while this study might be pretty cool, another 2016 study from the International Journal of Nanotechnology could be even more awesome. It found that water might actually have two distinct liquid states. You probably know that all matter exists at one of five states: solid, liquid, gas, sometimes plasma, and very rarely Bose-Einstein condensate, where atoms start to act like waves. But in this study, researchers found that liquid water actually undergoes a change in its properties, how it behaves, when it's cooled from 60 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees. They're calling this the crossover temperature. In other words, even though water looks identical just above and below this crossover temperature range, it has different properties and thus potentially has two distinct types of liquid water. When water is cooled, it loses its ability to store electrical energy, also called its dielectric constant. Researchers thought that this happened in a linear fashion. But at the crossover temperature, it gets a kink in this linear line. This small change impacts other physical properties of the liquid too, like the speed of sound in water and how it conducts heat. Above 60 C, liquid water's chemical properties look more like what we'd associate with water vapor or steam. Below that, the properties appear more ice-like. And although the change is small, it may have a dramatic effect on molecular systems. The researchers looked at how proteins behave in water at the crossover temperature. And around the 60 degree mark, certain systems of proteins go from being stable to unstable. The researchers think that the physical changes in water at this temperature may be impacting the proteins directly. With future research, this could help us learn how certain diseases infect us. The two states of liquid water could also change how we work with microscopic systems like nanoparticles, which are sensitive to this crossover temperature. So water is still kind of mysterious, and there's probably a lot more to learn about it. I mean, only recently have scientists learned how it's even able to conduct electricity, or the fact that forcing it through tiny nanotubes changes its boiling and freezing points. Even though it's all around us and inside of us, that's no reason to take water for granted. We can't do episodes like this without our sponsors. Thanks to Graze for sponsoring this episode of DNews. Graze makes snacking exciting by combining wholesome ingredients with flavors we all love to create over 100 nutritionist-approved snacks. Go to graze.com and enter the promo code DNews to get a free sampler box delivered right to your home or work. All of these things we're learning about water are super cool, but what about hard and soft water? What's the difference between those? Check out this video here. Got any other water-related questions? Ask us down in the comments. Please subscribe and come back for more DNews.